going to demonstrate some saw blade cutting. Going to be demonstrating using the MK saw. It's a 10 inch, so obviously that'll be the size blades that we're using. Very simple, goes on here, a backer plate and the nut holds the blade in place. This little piece of rubber is supposed to stop all the spray. It doesn't do a really good job of it, so I built myself a little tent out of plastic to contain the majority of the spray. This is a simple machine. The wrench for changing everything is right here. Hold that up. I'm going to start with the result blade. This is probably one of our more popular blades. It's very thin. Being thin makes it somewhat fragile, so don't try and fold it and put it in your pocket. The result blades do not come dressed for any particular direction. So I wrote on it for myself in my own direction. This is the outside, and the blade goes in this direction. This has not really been used, so I'm going to put it on the arbor, put the bushing on and the nut. And I'm going to back off a little bit on this so that the blade can seat well. Once it's on, tighten that. Carefully hold the blade and tighten the nut without bending the blade. That's tight. This goes down. Water is self-contained. This hose goes to a submersible pump that sits in this pan. So the water is constantly recycling. There's a drain plug here inside the pan, and this could be tapped so that it goes into a bucket, and then the submersible pump could be in the bucket. You do not need to keep adding water. Recycling the water is adequate for cutting with a diamond saw. The next and most important part, safety glasses. I'm gonna keep those eyes working the way they should. I have a little billet of BK7 glass, but as far as saw blades are concerned, glass is glass. Many of you may argue with me, but whatever's right for each of us. Now, starting with a brand new result blade, and this may be true of other blades as well, because it does not come dressed for a particular direction, I'm going to dress it. I can take two small slices off of this, and then I will always remember to keep it on this direction. And off we go. You can lock this up against this and just take two or three very thin slices away. You may notice that my hand is very close to the blade. You don't want to over-exaggerate this, but the blade is not sharp like a wood saw. So it's reasonably safe with safety considerations. To use your hands very close to it. All right, now having cut through the dressing stick, and of course, this is something we offer for sale. These little slices, too thin to use for anything, so off they go into the trash. The dressing stick, you'll see the black on here. What you're actually seeing is bits and pieces of metal from the blade. The dressing process, as it goes through the dressing stick is abrasive, it's aluminum oxide. Nothing top secret here. But as the blade goes through it, it wears just a little bit of the metal away that holds the diamonds, which expose fresh diamonds. It also sets the diamonds for the orientation for cutting. If you were to turn the blade around now, those diamonds would fall out because they wouldn't have the metal behind them. I'm gonna make a cut with this result blade. Maybe noisy, but I'm just gonna go about halfway through so you can see the speed that I'm cutting, and as always, the finer the cut you want, the slower you want to go. Now wait and make sure you see the water coming out, because water is critical. If you don't have water, you're going to burn the blade and crack your glass. Back out very slowly. With any saw blade, the speed with which you cut will give you the quality of your cut. This is a BK7 glass, which is a hard glass. You may find a different finish with a lead crystal or a soda lime. This is all for you to experience and learn. You can see a little bit of chipping blowout on the back. And this is going to be true of virtually any blade. The slower you go, the less that will happen. And I was not going terribly fast. We're going to do the same kind of cutting with the Husqvarna. Now you can see this has an arrow direction on it. So we will pay attention to that. That may mean it will not need to be dressed. This is also one that we've used, so I know it won't. So, same process. On the saw, flange, and tighten. It'll pass through the other cut, but you'll still be able to see the finish. This is a slightly thicker blade also. Waiting for the water. This is a super lock glass plus blade. It tended to go a little slower. I was pushing just as hard as the last one, but it wanted to cut slower. Cutting slower leaves a much nicer and finer finish, much less blowout. So again, illustrating speed and the fact that slow is your best friend when cutting glass. Now, the third blade we're going to do, this is the MK303. Professional. Here's the arrow of direction. Always pay attention for that if it's on the blade. And you can feel on the edge there are diamonds exposed. It's a little rough, so it should be up, good, and ready to go. The speed on that was very similar to the result blade. A little bit of chipping on top, just like the result blade, and beneath, a bit of blowout. Looking for comparable finishes, very similar to the result. Written in here is the MK215GL. It's their glass blade. Again, this is a new blade. It has been dressed. Here's the arrow out here, a little more obtuse, but it's going to go in this direction just like all the others. Onto the shaft, flange and nut. Now I will also say that if you're going to be setting up your saw and leaving the blade on the saw, which I think is rather typical, a little bit of grease on the threads will be your friend, because you don't want this to rust together and have to bend and destroy the blade to get it apart. So a little grease on the threads. Come down, and we're going to go for another cut. And in we go. That did not seem happy. So if you paid attention, when I was making that cut, I got about that far into it. If you noticed, there may have been little red sparks as it was making friction. I noticed it, so I stopped immediately. I'm now going to dress this blade. Two or three cuts again off the end, and we'll see if that helps. It should. You may think we're basically wasting our dressing block. It's a tool, and this is what it's designed for. I'll cut in a different place so we can see the difference. So this little spot is where I started before I felt it needed to be dressed. If you can look into the cut a little bit, there's a little bit of mark there from the metal that was being left. The cut itself went a little quicker after it was dressed, which it's supposed to. Again, small amount of chipping, but still on the back there is blowout. Okay, once again with the 215 GL, I may have gone a little fast, so I'm going to go a little slower so we can see if there's significant difference in the cut. Now, I will say that going slower gave the feel of a finer cut. There is less chipping above. And less chipping below. This is the slower cut. This is the faster cut. You can see how different blades do give different finishes. And the speed with which you cut will make a difference also. If you're cutting pattern bars, if you're cutting wine bottles, if you're cutting blocks of optical edge crystal, you will have to determine from your own experience the speed to give you the effect or the finish that you want. But this little test was a lot of fun. Who wants a slice of pie?